many stars, too many incensed by one man's journey from the past. In Iceland, where the mountain stood with pride, they set off with their guide to reach the mountain side. One for safety through the long descent into the crater of volcanic rock beware. Look up from our telescopic lens, one star for us to share. We continue on our
imperceptibly passed from reddish brown to bright yellow. Their way lit by crystals appearing as lighted globes, they continued through the lava gallery, which gently sloped until they reached the intersection of two roads. Without hesitation, Professor Lidenbrook chose the eastern tunnel, and the journey continued through a succession of arches appearing before them as if they were the aisles of a Gothic cathedral. The walls were enhanced with impressions of rock weeds and mosses from the Silurian epoch. The eastern route they had taken had come to a dead end. With 3 days' walk back to the fork to find Arne Saknussemm's original route, they found their water rations were limited to 1 day. Knowing their only chance of finding water was on that route, They set off for the fork, and there, finally, they fell, almost lifeless, on the third day. After sleep, they continued down the other tunnel in their quest for water, and while searching on his own, Hans the guide heard the sound of water thundering behind a granite wall, and with a pickaxe, attacked the wall so as to allow a stream of boiling water to enter and cool in their tunnel. Not only had they found life in the water, but they'd also found a flowing guide to the center of the earth. They called the stream the Hans Bath. Replenished with the water, the journey continued with haste, but somehow they find themselves separated. Professor Lidenbrook's nephew, Axel, found himself alone. His mind was seized with unparalleled fear, and he saw memories of home flashing before him. His fiancée, Gråben, his house and friends in Hamburg. He saw hallucinations of all the incidents of the journey. And unworthy as he felt, he knelt in fervent prayer, and then in panic, he ran blindly through a tunnel, only to reach a dead end, where he fell panting for breath. In the darkness he cried, voices, 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 he heard voices. He heard his uncle's voice. Due to the shape of the gallery and the conducting power of the rocks, his uncle's voice was uncannily traveling around the walls. And by means of their chronometers, they discovered they were 4 miles apart. So Axel set about the task of rejoining the professor and their guide.